So I'm joined here today by Ben Roberts from University of Brighton. You're the Artistic Director for the new Centre for Contemporary Arts, is that right? And tell us all about it.
Yeah, that's right. Thanks, Mark. So the Centre for Contemporary Arts is a new contemporary arts centre based in the University of Brighton, which will be programming a year-round series of exhibitions by contemporary international artists, some emerging, some more established. We'll also be putting on programmes in the Salis Beni Theatre, so there'll be lots of dance and films and other events involved there. And finally, we'll be having a big programme of public participatory projects, talks and events that people can come and get involved with, meet the artists and find out more about the work that we're showing there.
And it's quite a major investment, isn't it? So you've basically kind of refurbished the whole area, kind of knocked a few walls down and...
We haven't knocked walls down. We've taken some down. Over the years in an art school, walls get built, as you can imagine, year on year. So we've tried to strip back some of the architecture in the galleries to make them a little bit truer to the original vision of the architect. But it is a big investment from the university, who are really sort of supporting the idea that this will be the first major contemporary art space in Brighton being open for 20 years or so. So it's a big project. It's going to be working across two of our premier spaces in our Grand Parade site.
Yeah.
So right in the middle of Brighton, it's a great location. The spaces look beautiful, and hopefully we'll be able to welcome not just artists, but a whole new public into the university and into what will be Brighton CCA.
Yeah, and the purpose of it is to kind of, you're going to, first of all, to get some kind of major artists down into Brighton, but also to get, it's a good kind of icon for the university, isn't it? A good kind of a centre where you can display, you know, what Brighton University is all about.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, we're trying to be responsive to our location in an art school, so we're about experimentation and discovery and finding out new things, and that extends to what we're offering our audiences. So yeah, we'll be inviting artists that are major figures but you may not have heard of yet, or that will be major figures in the future. But in terms of the university, you know, this is an art school, and having major artists come there to speak about their work, to talk to the students, and for the students to find out about them, and for the public to come and find out a little bit more about what's going on in the university, and how perhaps other areas of research that are in environmental science or geography or physics are of interest to artists, and how artists are using that knowledge. So we'll be trying to sort of make some connections between the different sorts of activity that are happening all across the university.
And what kind of artists do you think you can get in this new space? Can you get some of the major artists to be there?
Yeah, I think so. I very much hope so. Yeah. We are working with a lot of younger artists, obviously, and we're trying to be as diverse as we can. But because the South Coast has a lot of very sort of white cube museum type spaces already, we want to be something a little bit different, and perhaps be something a little bit that's more about Brighton in some ways. So you will be getting major artists coming down to the gallery to be showing work, but it perhaps might not be the sort of work that you would expect from them or know, because we'll be commissioning a lot of artists to make new things and trying stuff out in their work, which perhaps they haven't had the opportunity to do yet, which is a real problem for artists sometimes, because everyone always wants them to do the same thing again. Yeah. So this will be a chance for us to find out more about the artists that we know and love, and to discover some new ones as well.
And it's always a good thing for the public to have access to art, isn't it? And to introduce more people to, you know, to artists and to, you know, exploring art.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, I think art's place in our society and in culture is a really valuable one. Mm. It's one of the few places where we can have a really open and nuanced discussion about things that are going on around us, about our understanding of the world, and I think artists have a huge amount to contribute to that. Not only that, they bring in, you know, a huge amount of interest to the country. You know, the creative industries in the UK is one of the most thriving and growing industries that brings in, you know, billions of pounds to the country, and culture is all part of that. So the richer our culture, and the more we can support artists to, you know, break new ground and make discoveries and infuse people with ideas, that's so much the better.
Yeah. So you open up on the 19th of October. I know Latest TV will be covering that. So what's going to be the first exhibition? What can people look forward to when you open?
Yeah, it's going to be super exciting. The 19th of October, 6 o'clock. Everyone is welcome to come. We're opening with two different shows. First one is a senior German artist called Franz Erhard Walter, who is now in his 80s, but has been working with sculpture and performance for decades, and is a really seminal artist who's influenced the practice of lots of famous artists that you may have heard of, like Tino Segal, for example, Jeremy Deller. And he is going to be showing in our South Galleries with a collection of sculptures and performance work. We've also got a retrospective by a performance collective called Dog Kennel Hill Project, who are a younger group, but they've been working together for about 15 years, and this is the first time that all of their practice has been brought together. So there'll be film work, they work with dance and theatre as well, so we'll be doing things in the theatre with them. There'll be lots of participatory workshops and things that people can come and get involved with to help them make some new work that we're commissioning. On the night itself, we'll have some live music as well, and you'll be able to see the refurbished galleries that we talked about just now too.
Perfect. Have you got a website that people can go to as well?
We do indeed. Yep. It's www.brightonCCA.art. You can also follow us on Instagram, so we're Brighton CCA.
Perfect. Ben, thanks for coming in. All the best with the opening.
Pleasure. Thanks so much.